segment today dealing with pine cones. And what got me thinking about it was a lady wrote to me and said that for some reason black stuff was coming out of her pine cones that she had picked up in Flagstaff. And she didn't know what it was and how could she clean them and get rid of it. Well, what it was are bugs. There's bugs in pine cones that you pick up off the ground or take off the tree. They're always there. And before you use them for crafts, you want to get rid of them. So what you do, cover a baking sheet with foil. And then just lay your pine cones, your plain pine cones on it. Then you're going to take it over and you're just going to pop it in your oven like this at 200 degrees. So we're at 200 degrees. You'll leave it in there for 45 minutes. Take them out, let them cool. And then you're ready to do any craft you want to. And one that I've been doing this year that I want to tell you about is I've been dyeing pine cones with food coloring. And as you can see, what I've got here, I did red ones and green ones. And you can take some wire and wire around it, put it on a stick, and use it like a flower in a vase. But I use it just in a bowl full of pine cones because they look so nice. So I want to tell you how quick and easy it is to do. You're going to take 2 quarts of water. Now, I like it to be hot water. It opens the pine cone up. It accepts the dye better. And I always put a quarter cup of white vinegar in, which also allows that dye to stick to that pine cone better. Then you're going to put your pine cones in and make sure that they fit in the container you're using. Push them down in good, and you're going to leave them for sure overnight. You can leave them up to 24 hours. Now, when they come out, you're going to just take your pine cone and like this one that I've already dyed, it would be wet. Take it out with tongs and I just sit it on an old box or anything to let it dry. And it's going to take about a day or so to dry because they absorb a lot of water. Once it's colored, the color doesn't come off. They're safe, they're natural, they're pretty. You can put some glitter on them. And I had fun, and it's a great craft for you and the kids to do, especially here in Arizona. You can do it outside. Now, what about scenting pine cones? Well, there's an easy way to do that. You can use just a natural pine cone, or you can use a dyed one. And you'll just pick a fragrance that you like. Now, this one is a balsam, and balsam gives you that Christmassy smell. So what I do is when I'm going to use the oil on it, and any essential oil is a good thing to use, by the way, I warm it up first in the oven for a few minutes. Then just shake that oil into those lips on the pine cone and shake it on really good. Then the secret is put the pine cones that you have scented into a plastic bag. When you put it in the plastic bag, it allows it to soak in really, really well. Leave it for a day or so. When you take it out, they will smell so good. And unlike those nasty ones you buy at the store that smell like cinnamon and you can hardly breathe around them, these will smell like whatever fragrance you want, and they are fabulous for the holiday. To find information on this complete segment, how to do any of these things, go to queenofclean.com under SCNonTV. I always have it up there for you. Check me out on Facebook and Instagram at Real Queen of Clean. Thanks for talking dirty with the Queen of Clean.